The practice has been that the president decides on who receives the official all-state funeral upon demise, except for sitting members of parliament and sitting members of the Supreme Court, whose fate is decided by the Administration of Parliament Act and the Administration of Judiciary Act, respectively. This prompted the Wakiso District Woman Member of Parliament, Betty Itho Naruima, to demand the criteria used in honoring dignitaries with official send-off.
Like the way we lost Honorable Kato Luvuama and we've now lost Honorable Francis, we would wish to know from government the very people who are supposed to have those official burials, even at times were brought, so that I can adjust my will well. Later on, when I leave this earth, people and my family is not disturbed by any other arrangements.
That has been raised here several times about determining who is to be brought here. In Uganda now, it's only the president who says bring A, B, C, or the other one. Recently, Madam Speaker, I talked to the AG when our former judge of the Supreme Court laid in state. And indeed, the public didn't know that the judge had to stay here for night because of the law we brought. And it looked as if it was ugly in public. So what we are asking, Madam Speaker, is government to bring a law which determines who is supposed to be brought to parliament.
On Sunday, the former MP for Kabweri County, Francis Gonahasa, passed on, barely a month before another former legislator, Kato Luvuama, passed on. Now the House is divided on the proposal to have former MPs honored with official funerals.
Policy of laying in the state should come out. Several former MPs are important citizens of the country. So if they can also be included in that list, they're better. You know, that's one of way of honoring them and respecting the period they served. Their mother country. So I would support that.
Parliamentary Act, the Standing Order Act, and the rest, they are very clear. Why do they need the bodies of the former MPs to be brought here? We shall not have any other business but only what? Eulogizing ex-members of the what? Or parliament, or former members of parliament.
However, the Administration of Parliament Act only provides it to sitting members of parliament. Although the Administration of Judiciary Act provides that the body of a sitting Supreme Court judge is not only laid in state, but spends a night in state. Some legislators say it is not necessary and want the law to be changed.
Laws are very, very clear. When you look at the Administration of Judiciary Act, the Supreme Court judges will lie on state. And that's why you find the body of Justice Araj, the body of Justice Opi Aweri was lying here overnight. The Administration of Parliament Act is also very clear. When a sitting member of parliament dies, your body will be brought here, but you will not lie here.
Say it's a mistake and we have to amend it. That the Administration of Judiciary Act is saying that a Chief Justice, a Judge of the Supreme Court, should be accorded a state burial. It's not proper.
In this regard, the Attorney General, Kiryowa Kiwanuka, assured the House that the Ministry of Public Service is in final touch with the funeral policy of the government that will iron out all confusion around the criteria for honoring the dead.
Honorable Speaker, like you've correctly stated, we have various laws that are providing for the various persons. Administration of Parliament Act, public service orders, the
judiciary.
However, what we are doing right now, right, Honorable Speaker, is we are getting all these provisions from the different statutes and consolidating them into a funeral policy for the whole government so it can be in one place. Public service should be coming with this.
In the 10th Parliament, the House was treated to an embarrassing situation when the body of former Attorney General Peter Nyombi was taken to Parliament and was never received by the Speaker of Parliament. Though the body lay in state, it was not taken to chambers for MPs to pay their tribute to his works. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.